6 p.m. Good evening, everyone. Let us sanctify this hour by the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Queen of Heaven and Earth. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Queen of Heaven, rejoice. Hallelujah.
Glory to be. Hallelujah.
Is now risen just as he said. Hallelujah.
Pray for us to God. Hallelujah.
Rejoice and be glad, O Virgin Mary. Hallelujah.
For the Lord has risen indeed. Hallelujah.
Let us pray. O God, who by the resurrection of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, brought joy to the world, grant that through the intercession of the Virgin Mary, his mother, we may attain the joy of eternal life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May his divine assistance remain always with us.
And with the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The divine assistance is the Holy Spirit. So I welcome you this evening to our second day of Novena. So let us enter into our Novena prayer time.
Send down your fire, send down your fire, send down your fire, oh Holy Spirit, breathe our love, living us, come, oh Holy Fire, send down your fire. Detaching us from worldly pleasures
that could in any way separate us from God. They that fear the Lord will prepare their hearts, and in his sight will sanctify their souls. Pray. Come, O blessed Spirit of Holy Faith, penetrate my inmost heart, that I may set you, my Lord and God, before my face. Forever help me to shun all things that can offend you, and make me worthy to appear before the pure eyes of your divine majesty in heaven, where you live and reign in the unity of the ever-blessed Trinity, God, world without end. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be,
world without end. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is
now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, it's now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, it's now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Come, Holy Ghost, to eat of us.
From the smallest sin against you.
Mercifully guard my every thought, and grant that I may always watch for your light, and listen to your voice, and follow your gracious inspiration. I cling to you, and give myself to you, and ask you by your compassion to watch over me in my weakness, holding the pierced feet of Jesus, and looking at his five wounds, and trusting in his precious blood, and adoring his open side and stricken heart. I implore you, adorable Spirit, help of my infirmity, so as to keep me in your grace, that I may never sin against you. Give me grace, O Holy Spirit, of the Father and the Son, to say to you, always and everywhere, speak, Lord, your servant is listening. We pause for a second. Just hear God uttering one word to you, saying something to you.
Come, Holy Spirit, hear us calling. Come, Holy Spirit, hear us calling. Come, Holy Spirit, hear us calling. Come, Holy Spirit, hear us calling to you. Come, Holy Spirit, hear us calling. Hear us calling. Hear us calling. Hear us calling to you. Come, give your grace.
Come, Spirit of counsel, and guide us along the straight and narrow path to our heavenly home. Come, Holy Spirit. Come, Spirit of life, and strengthen us against every evil spirit and interest which will separate us from you. Come, Holy Spirit. Come, Spirit of knowledge, and teach us the shortness of life and the length of eternity. Come, Holy Spirit. Come, Spirit of godliness, and stir up our minds and hearts to love and serve thee, the Lord our God, all our days. Come, Holy Spirit. Come, Spirit of fear of the Lord, and make us tremble before and reverence before your divine majesty. Come, Holy Spirit.
There's gonna be a revival in the land. There's gonna be a revival in the land. In the north, in the south, in the east, in the west. There's gonna be a revival. There's gonna be a revival. There's gonna be a revival in the land. There's gonna be a revival in the land. There's gonna be a revival in the land, in the north and south, in the north, in the south, in the east, in the west. There's gonna be a revival in the land. For those who are watching now, brothers and sisters, we go straight into Holy Mass, our entrance in 275, if you have your hymnals. Praise the Lord in many voices. Let us all rejoice, for the Lord is our King. Let us shout to the Lord, let us sing, oh let us sing. We can trust in Him and the word of His hand, for His justice and mercy is on every land. And by the light of this evening, all the heavens came to be. By the hand of His mercy, He is our Father, the Father of His mercy, and He will never let mercy go away. So praise the Lord, yes, praise the Lord, oh praise the Lord in many voices. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord in many sounds.
Gifts of the Spirit as we are exploring during these days of Novena. So yesterday, we looked at the gift of wisdom. Today, we are going to look at the gift of knowledge. So to prepare ourselves to enter into this holy mass, we say, your kingdoms of the earth sing to God. Praise the Lord who ascends above the highest heaven. His majesty and might are in the skies. Hallelujah. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, as we prepare for the coming of God's Holy Spirit with his gifts, so that we will bear fruit, fruit that will last, let us acknowledge that we have sinned. We have fallen short of the glory of God, and the wages of sin is death, but the Holy Spirit is a giver of life. So let us ask God's pardon and forgiveness as we prepare to celebrate the secret mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that
I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask the Blessed Mary ever-Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen. Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, Holy God and Son, Lord God. Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God.
For 40 days, he had continued to appear to them and tell them about the kingdom of God. When he had been at table with them, he had told them not to leave Jerusalem, but to wait there for what the Father had promised. It is, he had said, what you have heard me speak about. John baptized with water, but you, not many days from now, will be baptized with the Holy Spirit. Now, having met together, they asked him, Lord, has the time come? Are you going to restore the kingdom to Israel? He replied, it is not for you to know times or dates that the Father has decided by his own authority. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you. And then you will be my witnesses, not only in Jerusalem, but throughout Judea and Samaria, and indeed to the ends of the earth. As he said this, he was lifted up while they looked on, and a cloud took him from their sight. They were still staring into the sky when suddenly two men in white were standing near them, and they said, why are you men from Galilee standing here looking into the sky? Jesus, who had been taken up from you into heaven, the same Jesus will come back in the same way as you have seen him go up there. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
God goes on with shouts of joy, God goes on with trumpet blast, God goes on with shouts of joy, God goes on with trumpet blast. All people clap your hands, cry God with shouts of joy, for the Lord the Most High we must fear, great King over all the earth. God the trumpet blast. Sing praise for God, sing praise. Sing praise to our God, sing praise. God goes out with shouts of joy. God goes out with trumpet blast. God is King of all the earth. Sing praise with all your skin. God is King of all the nations. God reigns on his holy throne. God goes out with shouts of joy. God was out with trumpet blast. God goes out with shouts of joy. God was out with trumpet
Second reading, a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. May the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, give you a spirit of wisdom and perception of what is revealed, to bring you to full knowledge of him. May he enlighten the eyes of your mind so that you can see what hope his call holds for you, what rich glories he has promised the saints will inherit, and how infinitely great is the power that he has exercised for us believers. This you can tell from the strength of his power at work in Christ, when he used it to raise him from the dead and to make him sit at his right hand in heaven, far above every sovereignty, authority, power, or domination, or any other name that can be named, not only in this age, but also in the age to come. He has put all things under his feet and made him as the ruler of everything, the head of the church, which is his body, the fullness of him who fills the whole creation. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
Jesus showed himself to the 11 and said to them, go out to the whole world, proclaim the good news to all creation. He who believes and is baptized will be saved. He who does not believe will be condemned. These are the signs that will be associated with believers. In my name, they will cast out devils. They will have the gift of tongues. They will pick up snakes in their hands and be unharmed. Should they drink deadly poison, they will lay their hands on the sick who will recover. And so the Lord Jesus, after he had spoken to them, was taken up into heaven. There, at the right hand of God, he took his place, while they, going out, preach everywhere the Lord's working with them and confirming the word by the signs that accompany it. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters, we hear in the second day of Novena, as we pray for the coming of God's Holy Spirit, we pray on this second day for the gift of fear. And this gift of fear comes from the sevenfold gifts. But we are not going to focus on the gifts, the sevenfold gifts. However, you may recognize that some of the gifts that are mentioned as the seven gifts of the Holy Spirit is also found in the scripture that we are using over these days of Novena, which is 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verses 8 to 11. Here the Apostle Paul lists 9 gifts. And one of the gifts that we will see as listed as a sevenfold gift, and also in this gift list by St. Paul, is a gift of wisdom, which we spoke about yesterday. Another such gift that is also listed in the sevenfold gifts and listed in St. Paul's listing of 9 gifts is also the word of knowledge. So today we want to follow the listing of St. Paul. So we will be focusing on the word of knowledge. But before we get to the word of knowledge, just a reminder of yesterday. The word of wisdom. The word of wisdom falls in the category of the gifts of revelation. There are 3 gifts of revelation: the word of wisdom, the word of knowledge, and the discerning of spirits. So tomorrow's talk will be the discerning of spirits. Yesterday's talk was a word of wisdom. And I want to highlight for you a simple way to really understand the gift of wisdom. So I'm going to test your Bible knowledge, because you should know this story. In the Old Testament, who is considered the wisest man that ever lived? And I see already you know the answer. The answer is King Solomon, the son of King David. And Solomon, as a child, the voice of God came to Solomon, and Solomon was offered many gifts, but he said the gift that he wanted was wisdom. And wisdom is that gift which helps us to make wise choices. It helps us to make wise decisions. It is the mother of all the other gifts of the Spirit, because with the gift of wisdom, you use all the other gifts. And the famous story of Solomon, and we see Solomon's wisdom really spread throughout his kingdom and the far-reaching kingdoms of the world as they knew it in his time. What is that story? Some of you already know. There was a dispute between two women. And these two women were fighting that the child that they had belongs to this one or that one. Who was really the mother of this child? Because one of the women, their child died, and Solomon needed to make a decision. He needed to make a choice. So what did Solomon do? He said, using wisdom, without knowledge. He is going to use wisdom without having any knowledge. Remember, wisdom is a mother of all gifts. So with wisdom, in making the decision, he will also be given knowledge. He will also be given discernment. So yesterday talk, you would have heard word of knowledge and discernment mentioned, because wisdom is going to use it. So here it is, Solomon has no knowledge, but he has to make a serious decision. He has to make a choice. So word of wisdom came. He did not get the knowledge who exactly was the mother. So what did he say? He said, well, bring my sword. I'm going to cut this child in two and divide it equally, because he had no knowledge who is the mother. He couldn't discern who was the mother. So he used wisdom. He's going to make a choice. He's going to make a decision. I'm going to slice this child in two. And what happens? One of the ladies threw herself and said, no, don't, because the child will die. It is better you give it to the next woman. And Solomon knew then and there. Then he got the knowledge. Then he got the discernment. The woman who threw herself and said, don't kill the child. That is a real mother. That is a real mother. And he gave the child to that woman. That is why with wisdom, we don't look at qualifications of someone. We don't look at who the person is or is not. But we look at the decision when they are faced with perplexing and confusing problems. How are we going to solve it? We need wisdom. Our nation and throughout the world, we need that gift more than ever. How are we really going to deal with the situation of our lives? We need to make wise decisions when we don't have the knowledge. Because we live in a time of great uncertainties. We have, some people may not even have discernment, but you can have the gift of wisdom. Wisdom is a mother of all. So when we use wisdom, you use wisdom even without having knowledge. You can use wisdom without even discerning the story of Solomon. My dear brothers and sisters, but what is word of knowledge now? Well, word of knowledge, it fits in so beautifully as yesterday with the gospel tonight. Jesus is speaking to his disciples, and he says to them, these are the signs that will be associated with believers. He is actually telling them how they will identify believers. They don't know. They don't know how will they identify. And tell them, these are the signs. Is Jesus saying to the disciples, well, my dear brothers, go and dip your hand in a snake pit to find out whether or not you're a believer? No. Is he saying, go and drink deadly poison? No, he is saying to you, from the gifts of word of knowledge, you will really know the believer. Because God will reveal the knowledge. So therefore, many times, there are many things we don't know. But how do we come to know? We come to know purely by the revelation of God. A very good example of this, and I love to use this example to show word of knowledge, even operative in a child. Because scripture says to us, that even before the commandments were given, it is written in our hearts. St. Paul says that to us. We have that knowledge of the commandments. And I like to use a child as an example. You ever see how a child operates? Many times, a child may see books on a shelf, and they know they are not to go and interfere with the books. They already, that knowledge is already there. It could only have been revealed by Almighty God. The commandments is already listed in their hearts. And their parents only have to look at them. And what does the child do? The child will keep looking back, waiting to see what will happen. They know they should not do it, but they will look back and they will go and pull down the books and look back and laugh. How did they get that knowledge? It was revealed by Almighty God. Well, in a more serious way now, word of knowledge from God is when God Himself, in situations of our life, we don't know what to do. Lord, I don't know what to do. Lord, help me to know what to do and when to do it. I need a plan, Lord. And you cannot know it on your own. And then the word comes. That is word of knowledge. Many times that happens when you are praying to Almighty God. You are faced with a situation in your life and you want to make a decision. Two things could be operative. Wisdom could come and you can make a wise decision without having the knowledge. But the knowledge of the situation will come. And then, without the gift of wisdom, you can make a wise decision. So my dear brothers and sisters, let us recognize that God gives us these gifts. He gives us these gifts so that we will be firm believers in Him. That is why many times when people are in prayer and they doubt Him, God reveals the word of knowledge. God brings a word of knowledge. So when that word of knowledge is spoken, what happens? The person begins to believe. So I invite now, as last night, I invite Torah to give you the practical side. So I might give you all the theoretical and all the teaching, but it's always good to have the lived experience of word of knowledge. As a priest, I don't like to bring word of knowledge, because sometimes when you bring word of knowledge, people quick to say, you know it because of confession. So that is why in confession, when people don't like to confess their sin, with the help of Almighty God, because God loves you so much. And people who have come to confession know this. And I often say, God loves you so much. He brings the knowledge so that you will confess your sin, so that you will be numbered among the believers and be blessed and set free. So I now hand you over to my dear friend, Dora.
the people of God, as we go with the gift of word of knowledge. The word of knowledge is a supernatural gift from God. Word of knowledge is not recognized in the psychic power. They operate for a seer person power. That's a different spirit that you'll find them operating with. The word of knowledge is the actual movement of the Holy Spirit exposing spiritual revelation to the person. So we operate with a different, not with our humanity, but with the Spirit of God within us. Word of knowledge enables us to know the secrets through the Holy Spirit that is not revealed to others. You know, maybe it's good to share the practical part of word of knowledge. Last night I was in prayer, you know, and so I looked at my dogs a little bit before I so they were all right. I have a dog who likes to hunt lizard and frogs and all these different things. So I looked and they looked all right. And then I went and I knelt in prayer. This must be around 10 to 12. I knelt in prayer. And when I was finished, you know, I felt the move. This is, again, operating in the spirit. I felt the move to go and check on my dogs. And then I saw some saliva on the ground. I said, oh, Lord, don't tell me this dog bite a frog. And, you know, and that was it. The move of prayer revealing something as well. Of course, she definitely did bite a frog, and that was a long story. But it is God, God in his saving grace knows that I wouldn't know if there was a frog in my yard. I wouldn't know if my dog bit a frog. But the power of God in prayer enabled me to go out there and save my dog's life. I give God the praise. Word of knowledge, you know, I remember when after the baptism of the Holy Spirit. You know, not all gifts are explained like how it's explained here. And I was in church. And you just get the gift of tongues, so you hear the tongues, but you don't know of the other gifts that you are able with right now, you are empowered with. And so I went to the church and there was a lady crying. I was in prayer, it was lunchtime. And there was a lady crying. And of course, you know, you don't know that you can hear the voice of God. And whilst there, I am hearing the voice of God say, go and tell that lady, I love her. So I looked and said, no, God, I don't think so. You don't want to be like that, but I don't think so. And I'm hearing this voice. God says, go and tell her. I said, no, God. And then I actually felt a shock. And I got up and I said, hi, you know, I am just praying here and God wanted you to know he loves you. And the lady started to cry so much. And then I said, God, oh gosh, Jesus, what to do? I don't know what to do because you really didn't know you were empowered with the word of knowledge. And then God says, tell her that she must break with the adulterous life. Now I don't know this lady. I never met her. I never saw her in church before. I said, God, hear what? Ask somebody else in the church. This is not for me to do. This is not my thing, God. I'm now coming in to learn about you. I don't know. And God says, tell her. I said, God, anything else you want me to tell her rather than this? God says, tell her. So I said, yes, sister, as I am praying for you, God says, you know, that to let you know that you must break with this adulterous relationship. Well, the lady started to cry even harder, and then I said, God, oh gosh, you're embarrassing me, what to do? And there it was, the Lord said, send out the confession. So I said, what you need to do is go to confession. Well, she didn't have any money and that kind of thing, so you know, you had to help out in the situation. And that woman went to confession. That woman was able to break the sin of adultery, to reconcile with her marriage. She, after what she her husband got ill, he died, and eventually she died. But she died changing her life because she believed in what God had to say to break the relationship. You see, God reveals through prayer something he wants to say. Sometimes somebody will come and they want you to pray with them, and you might lay hands on them to pray, and they said, you know, I have been suffering with such headaches. And then you start to pray, Lord God, you know, bring your healing on these headaches right now, and they might be in tongues. And then all of a sudden, something comes to mind. And what comes to mind is that this is not migraine that this person is suffering, but this person is suffering with a tumor. So you said, you see, as I pray with you, I get good tumor is coming to me. That maybe you have a tumor, so I break the power of tumor. And you know, you pray, you break the power, but for sure, when God reveals something, it comes true when it's operated under the anointing of the Holy Spirit. Sometimes in times when we went for deliverance, and we are delivering somebody, and you're praying over somebody for deliverance, to the power of God to deliver them. And you're praying, but you know, you might be gift of tongues, you might be breaking, whatever. But believe me, when you hit the jackpot is when something comes to mind that this person indulged with the cult, or the occult. This person belongs to witchcraft. And you might be thinking in your mind that there's a good Catholic, but only when you bring forward the word can the person be delivered. That's the operation of word of knowledge, where the Spirit of God enables you to reveal the secret of someone. You know, there was someone who had gotten kidnapped. And we were praying, they called me up and they said, Auntie so-and-so. And we were praying. And during that prayer, whilst I'm praying and calling on the power of God to reveal what's happening, and in the prayer I see them hitting him and slamming him up and all that. So every time God showed me what was happening, I would pray and break it, and break the power. And I'd pray, I said, God, let them throw him out of the heat now. Get fed up and throw him out. So when it was finished, because family members were there, and they knew what we were praying about, and when he eventually, exactly what we prayed about, that they held him out of the vehicle and he was released. But when he came and he heard what was happening, he said every single thing that God had revealed was indeed true. That everything we were praying for and we were breaking the power of it, it was indeed true. That's the power of God's revelation working in human beings. Now, brothers and sisters, you have to be careful, because if you are in sin and you are a person operating with word of knowledge, you could also bring forth a wrong word of knowledge. If you're in pride and it's a power thing, if it's a power play, you could bring forth a wrong word of knowledge for someone. Now, according to scripture, it says in Jeremiah 33, from verse 3, says, I will tell you great mysteries of which you know nothing. That's the word of knowledge. You get it even in John 16 from verse 1-3, from verse 13. The Holy Spirit will tell you of the things to come. Now, word of knowledge, it is for anybody, you know. The gifts of the Holy Spirit, it is for anybody. By the calling down of the Spirit upon people. But sometimes, it doesn't manifest immediately on a person. So sometimes things are coming to you, and how you would know you have that gift is through confirmation of the Holy Spirit. I remember I was in this group, because after being baptized in the Holy Spirit, nobody tells you you have any other gifts. You know that tongues and prophecies manifested, but you wouldn't know if you have the gift of signs and wonders and miracles, or the gift of healing, or the gift of word of knowledge, only when it is acted upon. And I remember calling up Father Taylor at that point in time. I said, Father, I don't know what's happening with me, but since this baptism, the laying on of hands, what happened is that I could watch somebody and I could know things with them. And if I touch them, I know even more. I know hidden secrets. And it's happening because when I tell them, they are confirming. So, I don't know what is happening, Father. What's happening? He said, well, what has happened is that you have received the gift of word of knowledge. All right? And then he joined us in this group where we were able to discern and to pray and to operate in the anointing of the Holy Spirit. And while we were in that group, I remember I felt so insecure in the group, you know, so because everybody was so knowledgeable and this kind of thing. And while we were in the group praying, I remember saying to the Lord, God, I don't like to be in this group, but because these people really have experience and I don't, I am not sure about whatever. Ask you for a word. Give me a word. So I am going because I felt that I wasn't worthy to be part of the group. And God gave me this word. So this moving with the operation of word of knowledge. And as God gave the word in scripture, I went to the group and then Father was interviewing everybody. Should they keep these people? You're not sure who should be there. So I know if one person should be there, it's me. Because I don't know the gifts. I just have the gift of tongues and all that. So if we had somebody who will take notes of every prophecy come by or whatever, and whilst I was there, and I was saying, but you know, God was saying so and so, and then, of course, Father invited each person to interview them to see if they should be part of the group. So I said, Father, I don't think I should be part of this group, because, you know, I asked God for word on the group, and this is what God gave me, but all these people really have the experience and the different gifts, and I just speaking in tongues, I have not started. And that's why you don't know when you God has empowered you. So I said, you know, I asked God for word on the group, and this, he said, God gave you that word. You spoke to anybody in the group? I said, no, Father, I asked God for a word on the group, and this is the word God gave me. And I really think that this should be my last day, because I don't think I could, you know, I could match up with these people. He said, all right, all the sessions ended. And he came up and he said, you know, I have spoken to, before I went down, because he was taking notes and I was saying what God says, okay, and I went down. And then somebody else just went down and they weren't interviewed, but there was notes being made. So I said, oh, well, should I take a note here for somebody? And as I look at the book, the person who's taking notes is not supposed to talk about anybody. You're supposed to take notes. So the person put, Torah doesn't seem to operate in the spirit of God. You know, but when I saw that, my God, you know, really, I was in a type of state. And then, I said, God, I know that I need to leave this group. And when Father came up, he said, you know, I've interviewed all of you of everything with the gifts and all that. And there is only one person know what word God gave me this morning for the group, and that's the person who wrote the thing. But God revealed to only one other person from this whole group, and that's Torah. And I am so shocked because he didn't even tell me. So the word of knowledge flowed for the group through the word that I brought forward. And sometimes you will meet people who will put down your gifts or make you feel that you don't know. But when the Spirit of God is moving in you, he enables you, he empowers you, and he proves himself through you that indeed what you are saying is correct. So, you know, don't be daunting at these gifts. We need the explanation of this. These gifts. You know what God said? Jesus, in Luke 10 from verse 23, he says, Jesus spoke to his disciples, say, happy the eyes that see what you see. For I tell you that many prophets and kings wanted to see what you see and never saw it, to hear what you hear and never heard it. When God is empowering you, you might meet others who will think, no, that's not the way. This is the way. The Spirit has different ways of expressing his anointing. And it has different ways because we encounter different people. And we encounter different situations. When you can bring a word of knowledge that will bring conversion, or will deliver somebody from evil spirit, or mend a marriage because God says so and God said this, then you can know you're operating in the power of God. It says, you know, in Amos 3 from verse 7 says, no more does the Lord Yahweh do anything without revealing his plans to his servants, the prophets. So God allows us to know exactly how to deal with a situation when we operate in the anointing of the Holy Spirit, in the power of God. And you know, just be careful in your faithfulness is going to bring glory to God. You will encounter somebody who will say, that's not the way to do it. But then, God will show you that that is exactly what I wanted. You have changed somebody's life. You have touched a soul. And so when you operate with the gift, you go like Daniel 2 from verse 28 says, but there is a God in heaven who reveals mysteries. And those mysteries, brothers and sisters, belong to us. We stand, I remember this man coming to pray. I'm laying my hands on him to pray, and he didn't really too like me to pray. I don't know why he was in line anyhow. So I said, what would you like? He said, just pray anything. And as I laid my hands on him, because I knew his wife, and I started praying, I said, well, brother, you're committing adultery. And he said, no, I am not. He said, no, I am not. You are wrong. I will never commit adultery. I said, oh, God, Jesus, this man embarrassed me. Then the Lord said to me, tell him, what was he doing with that woman in black short pants and a little white top in the car? Clear like that. I said, well, hear what God says, to tell you so and so. After that, he woke off the line and go. And then his wife came a few days later. And she said, Tora, I don't know what you did with my husband. But you just say, you see that woman down there? She just hit the nail on the head. Well, I didn't hit the nail on the head because I didn't know anything. But God hit the nail on the head. Because God exposed his secret to bring healing. That man experienced a great conversion because he didn't know that God will reveal his business. So many times God reveals your wickedness to bring you into holiness, not to shame you, not to embarrass you. So that power, that word of knowledge, as we explain it, that when the calling of the Holy Spirit comes, you might not see it direct on the day, but God will put you in situations where you have to pray. Like when I was praying last night and God just said, go on, check on the dog. That was a movement of God to save my dog's life. That is word of knowledge. Could be in prayer. You could be in the grocery line. And God could say, move from there right now. And as you move somebody past there and slip. That's the kind of word of knowledge. Word of knowledge operates with humanity in all different kinds of ways. And the scripture, you know, it makes it. Word of knowledge can tell your future plan. I was praying over my sister's house. She just witches and they couldn't get a priest. She said, Tora, just bless. So we go on the line and I'm praying and I say, okay, Misha, let's pray. I said, you know, as I am praying here, I am seeing a wedding taking place from your home. Somebody is getting married from your home. And then as I said that, she said, well, you know, my daughter is going around with somebody, but I don't think so, you know, I don't think so. I said, who? I said, yes, that's a guy. She's getting married to that guy. And so sad, so dumb. After a little while, about a year later, right there in the home, marriage took place. Right? She got married to the exact guy. Word of knowledge also, you might be praying with somebody, and as you pray, God reveals death. It can bring sadness. Because God is revealing that this person is not going to make it. Many times, like in the case of my father, in the case of my brother, I knew when they were going to die. Word of knowledge could tell you that you are in this position. God could tell me, look, I'm going to move you out of Pune and put you somewhere. Word of knowledge says you that. And as you pray, God gives the word of confirmation. So it's a gift that it's a mighty gift. What if it caused quarrel, if it caused disunity, if it caused sadness? You as a person operating with word of knowledge, you're going to end up hurting the very people that you love. But pray, because indeed, it is a gift of revelation. It is working together with the gift of wisdom, the power of God operating in humanity, where God reveals to simply you and I the secrets and the mysteries of our humanity. Amen. Praise God.
And my dear brothers and sisters, as I said, God reveals knowledge to us out of love. He loves us so much that he wants us to walk on the right path. He does not reveal your business for confusion or bacchanal. He reveals what needs to be revealed so that you will walk in holiness. You will make your walk in humility and obedience to experience salvation. So my dear brothers and sisters, before we conclude this talk tonight, I just want to mention, why do you think I like my good friend so much? We might not get along, and that's the beauty about it, because there are many people who come and need the help of Almighty God. And we don't talk to each other, and this person may go to her, and that person may come to me. And many times, the person will say, you know, it's the same thing she tell me. So my dear brothers and sisters, I said, it has nothing to do with the person. It is all about God's love. So my dear brothers and sisters, God will confirm the word of knowledge so that you will grow in holiness.
Amen.
So my dear brothers and sisters, we have heard the word of God. We have reflected on it. So let us profess the faith we believe in. And we are in the season of Easter, so we use the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into heaven. On the third day he rose again from the dead.
He ascended into heaven,
and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the living and the dead.
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Our Lord Jesus Christ ascends on high, and he has sent his Holy Spirit to be with us, to grant us divine assistance. So Lord God, as we cry out to you in our prayer, grant us the assistance we need to live a life of holiness. So we come before you, praying for our Holy Father, our Archbishop, all members of the clergy, that Lord, you have granted us the gift to shepherd your people. Through your grace, Lord, help us to lead your people to greener pastures. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Lord, we pray for our government. Lord, we ask that you grant them the gifts of wisdom, knowledge, and understanding to govern your people, to do what is best for our nation and for every citizen. Also direct the governments in this world, so that the decisions they make will be truly for the building up of your kingdom and the betterment of all. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Lord, we pray for family life. Lord, we pray for families, that you will grant them forgiveness and reconciliation. so that all families will become like the Holy Family of Nazareth, where there is peace, unity, and love. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We lift up those who are ill this very night, especially those afflicted and affected by COVID-19. That you, God, will grant healing in mind, body, and spirit. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
And Lord, we pray for all students, that you will grant them the knowledge that is needed so that they will be successful. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
And whatever else you ask of the Lord, I invite you to pray. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
So loving and merciful God, we thank you for these our prayers, those said aloud, those silent in our hearts. For all those who have died, show their forgiveness, O Lord, and welcome them into the eternal kingdom. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We make all our prayer with the intercession of Mary, our mother. Saint Joseph, our protector, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
At this time, we now continue with the Holy Mass.
Brothers and sisters, our Michigan is the recognized number 11 of God of all creation.
God of all creation, for the love that breaks, we have lived with you all, from the Father, field and main. For earth and sky are nurtured, and human hands have made, it will become forever, from life forever reigns. Because of your great goodness, given up your life, we have the gift to offer, the chalice to rewind. The fruit of your creation, and world of human skill, make it for us your children, eternal life is still. And now, Almighty Father, all of them will pray, that you have sent this offering which we have made today. And let it be for glory, your glory and your grace. And let it bring salvation and comfort for all days. And let it bring salvation and comfort for all days. And let it bring salvation and comfort for all days.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
Accept this sacrifice from your hands for the praise and glory of his name, all good and the good of all his holy church.
O God, whose only begotten Son, our High Priest, is seated ever living at your right hand to intercede for us, grant that we may approach with confidence the throne of grace and dare obtain your mercy through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, mighty eternal God, for the Lord Jesus, the King of glory, conqueror of sin and death, ascended to the highest heavens as the angels gaze in wonder, mediator between God and man, judge of the world and Lord of hosts, He ascended not to distance himself from our lowly state, but that we, his members, might be confident of following where he, our head and founder, has gone before. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy. Every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that by taking of the body and blood of Christ, we may gather into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jason, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, Now with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, your spouse, with the Blessed Apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced into the life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
Of the Saviors to man, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant to peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
I believe that you are truly present in the most holy sacrament of the altar. I love you above all things and desire to receive you into my heart. Since I cannot now receive you in your personal Eucharistic presence, I ask you to come into my heart spiritually and to give me the abiding presence of your love and comfort. I embrace you as if you are already within me, and I unite myself totally to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Holy Mary, Mother of the Eucharist, pray for me and for the entire world. Amen.
every day and learn to love you more. Come, Holy Spirit, follow me now. I need your anointing, something more power. I love you, Holy Spirit, your captivated my soul, and every day I learn to love you more. I'm reaching for your heart, you hold my life in your hand, drawing me closer to you, I feel your power in you, nothing compares to this place. Worship you, it's the red and the truth. Oh, come, Holy Spirit, follow me now. I need your anointing, come in your heart. I love you, Holy Spirit, you're captivating my soul, and every day I learn to love you.
Let us pray. May the gifts we have received from your altar kindle in our hearts a longing for the heavenly homeland and cause us to press forward, following in the Savior's footsteps to the place where for our sake he entered before us, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
So my dear brothers and sisters, just a gentle reminder that our stream of daily masses is at 10 a.m. So 10 a.m. we have holy masses, and the masses at 6 p.m. in the evening until Pentecost is for the Novena to the Holy Spirit. It is on Wednesday you will have to make a choice to watch one Mass before the other, because on Wednesday we also have the devotion to Our Lady. So if you watch our devotion to Our Lady first, then you can follow the Novena after. Or you follow the Novena first and then the devotion to Our Lady after. So my dear brothers and sisters, as you have heard our Prime Minister today, at the press conference. Tomorrow we go into a state of emergency with hours of 9 to 5. So do follow all the COVID protocols and measures so that God will bless us and keep us, and we too will do our part, keeping one another safe. So let us continue to pray for one another, and not only pray, let us do our part in making our nation safe and healthy again. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father and Son and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
So our Mass is ended. Go forth, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
So my dear brothers and sisters, do have a blessed night and be safe and continue to call on God's Holy Spirit, His divine assistance.
Our reception of him tonight, Days of Elijah. It's not going to be long, but if you have a copy anywhere around, you can use it.
All of Zion's new salvation comes.